everybody, and welcome to Faith on Friday Extra. This series is all about highlighting people, topics, and businesses that I hope you will find interesting, entertaining, always, always, always motivating and encouraging. And I'm your host, Rikki Smith. Today, I want to introduce you to Marvin D Cloud, who is the owner of my bestseller publishing company out of Houston, Texas. He is also the publisher of my book, Faith on Friday, A Deeper Dive, that you can get on Amazon. Hi, Marvin.
Hey, Rikki, how are you?
I am doing well. How about yourself?
I am doing wonderful.
Thank you so much for joining us today, because I know there are a lot of people interested in writing a book, finding out what publishers are and do. So who better to ask than the man himself? So
well, thank you. And this is a good time to be writing books.
Okay, we're going to talk about that. So first of all, Marvin, what does a publisher even do for an author?
Okay, well, a publisher is the one who puts everything together. You know, they take the manuscript, they take, they take it through the editing, take it through the layout, take it through the cover design, get the book printed, everything someone needs to publish a book. That's what the publisher does. The publisher is the one who usually, in a nutshell, the publisher is the one who puts up the money in the traditional sense. And we're going to talk about the other sense a little bit later.
Okay, so because that's interesting. That brings up the thing, because you hear a lot of people talking about self-publishing, and you just kind of brought up like the self-publishing versus the traditional way. So what's the difference there?
Well, there's a big difference. First of all, let me give a shout out to the self-publishers of the world, because it doesn't have the stigma that it used to have 20 or 30 years ago.
Really?
20 or 30 years ago, if you said, I self-published my book, first reaction, oh, it's no good. Nobody wanted to pick it up.
Right.
But that's not what it's like now. The quote self-publisher, and I really don't like that term, and I'll tell you why a little bit later. But the self-publisher of today is vastly different than the self-publisher of yesterday. Many big name authors are now turning to what I call the independent route. It's like in the R&B world or in the secular world, where musicians always wanted to be on the major label.
Sure.
But now many of the people on major labels want to be an independent, because if you're an independent, you get to control just about everything that you do.
Right.
So that's the major difference. Now, the self-publisher is someone, an individual who wants to be published, but they want to have control of everything. So they put it together themselves. Now, let's be clear. It doesn't mean that they do all of the work themselves, but they are in charge of hiring the cover designer. They're in charge of hiring an editor, which is a very important part of your book.
Definitely.
They're in charge of hiring the graphics designer and all of these things. Right. So that's why they're called a self-publisher, because they're not under a major label. This is something that they're starting themselves.
Right.
And it's a viable business. It's a real business, you know. So the reason I don't like the term self-publisher is because, Rikki, if I worked for McDonald's, you know, which is a major corporation, but then I decide to go and start my own hamburger stand, well, nobody's going to call me a self-hamburgler, you know, anything like that. I'm still a restaurant owner.
Right.
It's the same thing in the publishing business. Just because you don't have a major label behind you or a major imprint behind you doesn't mean that you're not a publisher. So that's why I don't really like that term.
Right. And then I think as authors, though, too, whether we are self-published or published in the traditional sense, guess what? End of the day scenario, we're authors. We still have books.
Yes.
And they still sell on Amazon and wherever else that you can buy books at. And that's all done by a publisher. You know, it's so funny you said that the authors then have control over certain things. I want you all to know he's not telling the truth. How do I know? When I published my book, I did not want this to be the cover. Marvin and I went round and round in circles about this cover. So he won. I'm just saying. So control is a relative term.
Well, you know, sometimes you know what's best. And what Rikki is not telling the complete truth about is that Rikki, although we see her now online and everywhere, Rikki was more like a wildflower. She didn't want anybody to see her, to know her. And when I saw that photo, my first reaction was, oh my God, that is beautiful. Mm-hmm. So if you had insisted a little harder, then yeah, the cover would have been whatever bland cover you had decided.
I could have won. Oh my gosh.
You could have won. However, I don't think you have any complaints about the cover.
I really don't. And you were right. You definitely knew better. So that being said then, Marvin, how do you go about selecting or finding a decent publisher?
Well, first of all, people who do what I do are a dime a dozen. You know, I've been doing this for 16 years. Mm-hmm. There are some people who have been doing this for 25 plus. There are newcomers on the scene. Mm-hmm. There are people with integrity. There are people who want to separate you from your money. Wow. The main thing is going, you know, word of mouth, finding out like yourself, hey, Rikki, who did your book?
Right.
You know, who helped you with your book? If you go online, and it's funny because I get a lot of clients, I do about 100 books a year.
Okay.
But I get a lot of clients who come to me in the Humble area, which is a suburb of Houston. I'm really not in Houston, but you know, I'm still right here. Mm-hmm. But we have our own mayor and city council and all of that stuff. But I have people who come to me and they say, oh, I wanted to have somebody that I can put my hands on, someone who right here in the city with me and all of that.
Right.
And 50% of my clients are from other states.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it doesn't matter. You know, I have clients from all over the country, you know, but I do understand sometimes you just want to see somebody. But I have many clients I've never met in person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we just do business online. We do business by phone. But you want to, you know, if they belong to the Better Business Bureau, you want to check the Better Business Bureau. Most of the people I come in contact with, they really want to help people.
Right.
But since this falls in the category of entertainment, there's some sharks out here as well.
Oh, sure.
You know, and so, and my thing is this, there's a difference between someone who make a mistake or maybe who cannot satisfy a client, or, because we all have that.
Right, right.
But it's a difference between that and someone who wakes up in the morning and say, let me see how many people I can trick.
Right.
Out of their hard-earned money. And so, and that's, so you, I mean, there are thousands of people who do this. You know, some of us a little better than others. Some of us may charge higher than the other.
Sure.
But getting something for cheap doesn't mean that it's better, but it also doesn't mean that it's worse. You know,
that is so,
have to look around.
Yeah. So in that being said, I know that because you do business all over the country, what's the best way for people to get in touch with you?
Well, right now they can contact me through my email, which is Marvin D Cloud. You got to put the D in there. MarvinDCloud@gmail.com. Email me. I do this full time. I live this stuff. I dream this stuff. So I only really take a break to go to church.
Okay.
And I'm not careful. Sometimes I'm thinking about books in church, but that's a whole nother story.
That's right. But, and that's okay, because we're going to make sure to put all of your contact information in the description below so people will be able to find you. Hey, while you're here anyway, go ahead, you all, and subscribe to our YouTube channel and make sure to give us a thumbs up. And we want to hear from you, so make sure you leave us a comment. So Marvin, before we go though, we have to play a game. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, the game is called This or That. And basically, I'm just going to give you a choice between one or two things, and off the top of your head, you just tell me which one you like the best. You ready?
So, okay, you're going to give me two things.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's try.
Okay, here we go. McDonald's or Burger King?
Burger King.
Batman or Captain America?
Batman.
Awesome. Going to the movies or movies at home?
Going to the movies.
Make the call or send the text?
Send the text.
Snickers or Three Musketeers?
Three Musketeers.
Dress up or dressing down?
Dressing up.
Thanksgiving or New Year's Eve?
Thanksgiving.
Fry it or grill it?
Grill it.
Morning person or night owl?
Morning person, all day long.
Oh my gosh. And finally, what is your favorite Olympic sport?
Say that again.
What is your favorite Olympic sport?
Okay, track.
Okay, a lot of people say that. Mm-hmm. Marvin, thank you so much for joining us and giving us your insight. What is the last thing you would need authors to know about finding or being a publisher?
Well, the first thing, they do need to understand that books don't sell themselves. So writing the book is just half of it. You have to have a plan in place. And I tell people, start thinking about your marketing plan before you really write your book.
That's good.
Because the last thing you want to do is spend a year or so writing a book, and then you have no plan, no action plan to move copies.
That is so true. That is so true. Marvin, thank you again for joining us. We appreciate you. Everybody, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time on Extra.